U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris may have already conceded defeat to her rival Donald Trump, but many of her supporters are still in shock as to why Americans gave Trump another shot at leading the country, despite his past transgressions. This report tells us what went right for Trump and what doomed Harris's bid to become the first female U.S. president.
The U.S. election was nothing short of historic. Americans were set to see a first, regardless of whether Donald Trump or Kamala Harris won. But by late Wednesday, it became clear the most powerful nation in the world would, for the first time, be led by someone who had been convicted, went through two impeachments, and faced 34 felony counts.
America has given us an unprecedented and powerful mandate. We have taken back control of the Senate. Wow, that's good. And the Senate races in Montana, Nevada, Texas, Ohio, Michigan, Wisconsin, the great Commonwealth of Pennsylvania were all won by the MAGA movement. They helped so much. Frankly, this was, I believe, the greatest political movement of all time.
Trump cruised to the 270 electoral votes needed to claim victory, winning almost all battleground states. Now the question is, just how did Trump, who only 4 years ago attempted to overthrow the government, regain the presidency? For Dr. Jay Gonzalez, professor of politics at the Golden Gate University in San Francisco, California, the Democrats committed a monumental blunder by not concentrating on gut issues.
That's why Donald Trump, won. He was more attached to the realities that, regular Americans, particularly those who are hurting because of the economy, Republicans are listening to them and providing actions that are really doable. Number one, the economy, right? When people are hurting across demographics, particularly millennials, Gen Zers, Gen Xers, all across generations, they're all hurting. And the Democrats didn't seem to have, an answer, for them. The second one is, of course, immigration. It's been lingering years and years. The number of illegal immigrants to the United States now number more than 10 million. That's a lot. That's two times the size of our ASEAN partner, Singapore, right? And included in that immigration group are criminal aliens who, under Democratic administrations, they have been very lax and very forgiving. And so this being lax and forgiving has been abused by some of these criminal aliens.
The economy was also in the spotlight in this year's election. According to data from Edison Research, about 31% of voters said the economy was their top issue, ranking second to the 35% who said the state of democracy mattered most to them. Voters who identify the economy as their primary concern overwhelmingly favored Trump over Harris, 79% to 20%. The high inflation of the past couple of years and its impact on perceptions of financial well-being were clear concerns that also drove voters toward Trump.
I think Harris and Democrats around the country spent about 80% of their time talking about abortion rights. And, clearly that was a driving and polarizing issue that impacted a lot of voters. But when you step back at the end of the day, far less than 1% of American voters are ever going to have to deal with abortion directly or indirectly. All voters have to deal with inflation, gas prices, home energy prices, less take-home pay.
For the Democrats to bounce back on this disappointing result, a political analyst says they will need to recalibrate their approach to voters.
They want a fix to the economy right now. They want prices to go down. They want to be able to afford homes, and buy homes. The Democrats really need to focus and make it really simple, particularly for the particularly for rural America, particularly for people who live in suburbia. Right now, their formula is very elitist.
As Democrats regroup following the defeat, Harris simply left her supporters with one promise: the fight they started is far from over.
So let me say, my heart is full today. My heart is full today, full of gratitude for the trust you have placed in me, full of love for our country, and full of resolve. The outcome of this election is not what we wanted, not what we fought for, not what we voted for. But hear me when I say, the light of America's promise will always burn bright. As long as we never give up, and as long as we keep fighting.